morning, dear students. Today we will discuss about how to verify the result. As you can see here, it is about the verification of the result. So how we will do it? As already we have done in our previous class, whenever the question is asking for the verification, we have to go by the LHS equals RHS method. Now, here the thing is, what will be LHS and what will be RHS? So let's see what will be LHS here and what will be RHS here. So what we will do, we will divide the whole space in two parts. Here, my LHS, I'm going to write it here, LHS, and here I'm going to write RHS. So LHS would be, first we will multiply the numbers and we will find the product, right? So here what we will find product. And then we will put the value in the product of the given expression, right? So let's start it. If I will find the product of the same number, the numbers are 3x minus y multiply 2x squared plus 5xy plus y squared. This is my number. I am going to multiply them directly. So first I will multiply this to this. What I will get? I will get 6x cube. Then I will multiply it with the second term. I will get plus 15x squared y. Right? Now I will multiply the same term with the last term. So what I will get? I will get plus 3x y squared. As we can see here, it is a square. Now we are done with the multiplication of the first term with the whole bracket. Now we will continue the same procedure with the second term, as already we have done in the previous class, right? So we will continue with y. So y into this number would be what? Minus 2x square y. Children, here you can notice it is a negative number, it is a positive number, so my answer will be in negative, right? Now we will just follow the same thing with the second number. So negative positive will give me negative, and when I will multiply this number to this number, what it will give me? It will give 5x y square, right? Now I will multiply this with the last term as well, so it will give me minus y cube. Why it will be a y cube? Because it is raised to the power 1 and it is raised to the power 2. That's why the power would be 3, and it is a negative and it is a positive number. So I will get my answer as negative number. Right? So we are done with the multiplication here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total 6 terms we have. Now we will see, we will find which of these terms are the like terms. And for that, where we need to focus? We need to focus on the variable part, right? So I'm going to find it now. X cube, no x cube term is here. So let the x cube or the y cube term first written here. So 6x cube minus y cube, right? So ye bhi ho gaya and this one also done. Now come to the next number. Here we can see x square y. It is x1 y square, it is x square y. So this and this, we can see these both terms are like terms. So we will write them collectively. We will write them together, right? So I have written it together. And you must have noticed here, where I have get that number beside this number, so I have not changed the sign. So always remember, in the first video I have discussed this, I have told you people, when we are changing the order of the number, we are not going to change the sign, right? Now, so now this term and this term also get done. Now we will see x1 y2, x1 y2. So they both are like terms, so we will write them together, plus 3xy square minus 5xy square. So here you can see, children, that this term and this term, these terms are the light term. So we will solve them as per their sign. So this will come as it is. Now positive negative operation will be subtraction. So 15 and 2, 15 minus 2 will be 3, 13 x squared y, right? 15 minus 2 will be 13 x squared y. Variable will come as it is, and it is a numerically bigger number, so it will be positive number, right? Here also we can see that they both are opposite, have opposite signs, so we will do subtraction. Now minus 2 x y square. So I hope you notice that here also that they are opposite, so we did subtraction here, and since 5 is a numerically bigger number, so my answer would be in negative. So children, this is the way we have multiplied the number. We got the product. All we know that product means the answer of multiplication. This is my answer of multiplication, right? Now what we need to do, as we have found the product of the given number, so in my LHS part, now I will put the value of the variables in the product only, right? So for that purpose, I have to erase it all. So I'm going to erase it now. Right? So the number is, so the product is 6x cube minus y cube plus 13x square y and minus 2xy square. This is my product, right? Now I'm going to put the value into it. So here we can see the x value is minus 2 and the y value is 2. So wherever x, I will put minus 2, and wherever y, I will put only 2. Right? So it will be multiply x cubed. We all know that when the numbers are written in this form, it means the numerical coefficient is getting multiplied with the variable coefficient, and the variable coefficient is getting multiplied with the variable coefficient. We have done when we have convert the terms into factors, right? So I can put the value of x here as minus 2 raised to the power 3. Now this minus would come here. Now y value is only 2 raised to the power minus 3 plus 13 multiply minus 2 raised to the power 2 multiply 2, right? This is the value of x and this is the value of y, right children? Now it is minus 2 multiply minus 2 multiply 2 raised to the power 2. Here also you can see x value is minus 2 and y value is 2. So here y raised to the power 2, that's why I've written 2 raised to the power 2. So I have put all the values of variable here in this product. Now the important thing to notice here, where most of the mistakes occur, that we get confused where to multiply, where to minus. So just see carefully. These are multiplying. These all are multiplying to each other because it is a term. This is this term. This is this term. This one is this term. And this one is this term. So let's solve them first. As per the board marks, we multiply first. And then we will go for the addition or subtraction, right? So here, 6 multiply minus 2 raised to the power 3 means minus 8. Kyun? Minus 2 into minus 2 into minus 2. Kitna ho jayega? Minus 8. That's why I've written minus 8 here. Right? Now, it will be only 8 because it is a positive 2. So positive 2 multiply 3 times will be giving 8. Right? Plus sign as it is. If I will solve this, so it will give me 4 into 2. And when I will solve this, it will give me 2 2s are 4. And 4 into 4. Here is a minus sign, right? So let me write this minus like this. Okay, so it will not be a problem. Or what we can do, that we can just change our sign right here only. what we can do, let multiply the sign here, as this is a positive number. So we can multiply these both sign. Negative and negative will give me positive number. So 2 2's are 4. Multiply 2 raised to the power 2 will also be 4. Now again, we will first multiply, complete the multiplication. So here you can see it will give minus 48, minus 8, plus. Now what it would be? It would be 13 into 6. So it will give us 13 into 6 would be what? It will be 78. Right? It will give us 78. Oh, sorry, there is a mistake. Now you can see that first we will perform multiplication. So it will give me minus 48, as one negative sign is here. This will come as it is. Now it will be what? 13 into 8. So when we will multiply 13 into 8, it will give 104 plus 16. Right? Now we can see, solve them first. Same sign, addition would be there. It will be 56. Sign will be of minus. Now we can add these both. So it will give us what? 16 and 4 will be 20. So 120. And now when we will solve them, opposite sign are there. So we will do subtraction. So it will give 10 gone 6 will be 4. And 11 gone 5 will give us 6. And the numerically bigger number is 120. So I will write positive sign here. So after a lot of calculation, what we got? We got the value of the product is plus 64. Now we have to see that if we were going to put the value of the variable in question directly. So whether we are going to get the same answer or not. So let's do that. Now in RHS part, 3x minus y and 2x squared plus 5xy plus y squared. This is my question. Now I am going to put the values of all variable in this. So 3 multiply x value is minus 2 and y value is 2. Done. Multiplication. Now 2 multiply minus 2 ka square plus 5 into minus 2 into 2 plus 2 square. Right. I have written y square a little down as the space is not here. Now what we will do? We will solve it. It is a multiplication. So minus 6 minus 2. And when we will solve this, what we will get? We will get 2 multiply 4. Why we are going to get 4 here? Minus 2 into minus 2 will give us 4. Plus 5 4s are 20. And plus into minus will give us minus. Right, children? Now plus 4. So here you have noticed how we have multiplied each term, as we have done here only. So now what we will get after solving them? Minus 8 multiply. And the moment I solve them, I will open the bracket. Now here it would be 8 and it would be minus 16. Now minus 8 multiply. When we will solve them, these both have opposite sign. So it will be minus 8. Now 8 into 8 will give us 64. And 2 negative sign we have. So answer would be positive. So here, children, you can notice that we have here also the answer is plus 64, positive 64. And my LHS was also positive 64. So it is being verified here that LHS equals RHS. Therefore, the result get verified that we have followed the correct procedure. Right, children? So this is the way we can verify the result of the given multiplication. I hope, children, you understood this. Thank you so much. Stay safe. Stay happy.